Hi folks, and welcome back to Diablo 3. Last time we left off, having spoken to Alaric, who has told us to go and find two tombs from the Warrior's Rest and the Crypt of the Ancients in the Festering Woods.
Ancient doom hangs upon these woods.
We've decided to keep Sean Bean with us because, quite frankly, I hate the scoundrel. He comes across as a bit of a penis.
Alaric's people?
And
they have been twisted.
I don't know. I didn't really want him with us. So we're encountering new enemies all the time. It looks like we've got some guys who kind of float around. I think they're called ghosts, who are able to kind of teleport all over the place and make our life a goddamn misery. What I'm doing is keeping up the kind of playstyle that I was showing off before, whereby we kind of lay down things to slow people, and then we just run away like a big sissy girl to avoid taking any damage. Okay, so we found the Crypt of the Ancients. We're gonna clear this area out.
This is amazing. It reminds me of being a child and searching for lost artifacts with Uncle Deckard.
Okay, so she's reminiscing about Uncle Deckard, which is great. Found more of these guys that summon people, and we've come across a minion here, which has the affix, as you can see at the bottom of his name when I hover over it. He is Molten, so he's setting fire to the floor, and also upon his death he explodes. These little bats are giving me all kinds of help.
I need more discipline.
So at the moment, when we try to use our kind of evasive manoeuvres, we do run out of discipline fairly quickly, so perhaps that's something I need to start being a little bit more aware of, is when to lay caltrops and when to just run away like a little sissy girl. Of course, both will help me run away like a little sissy girl, but that's just the way it is. Not necessarily a girl, just a sissy. Gender equal, of course. Okay, so we'll continue clearing this area out. As we can see on the mini-map again, there's an objective that we kind of need to head towards. And also we found a fleeting shrine, which increases our movement speed and also our pickup radius, which is great. So we can go out and pick up all of the hot girls from a greater distance than we could before. So that's really nice. We're getting a slight massacre kill, so I'm going to continue killing stuff as much as I can, but it's not going much higher than 17. But in doing so, we've leveled up to level 13, and we've unlocked a new skill. This new skill is Preparation. We've also unlocked a passive skill called Blood Vengeance, and that's about it for now. So let's have a look. Preparation instantly restores 30 discipline. So what we could do now is we could either choose between having Vault all the time or having Caltrops, or we could leave our current setup as it is. I quite like our current setup, though we do run out of discipline. We'll see how we go for now with the current setup. Also, we unlocked... let's just click on it so it stops shining around. We also unlocked a new passive. The maximum hatred is increased by 25. In addition, you gain 30 hatred and 3 discipline when you're healed by a health globe. Again, I'm actually quite enjoying being able to sprint for a little while after doing our roly-poly. So we'll keep as is for the time being. Good stuff. Okay, but we have found a beacon of light, which is just fantastic. Is there anything else down here? Can't get down that way. There's a whole lot of stuff down here. I don't know whether we do need to kill any of this, but we're going to fire out some Ebolas, because if you look at this, when they do explode, they are actually doing a decent amount of area of effect damage, AoE damage. So that's nice. And we got a bonus for killing a bunch of things all in one go. So, straight on to the Beacon of Honor. Light the beacons! I will stop with the Lord of the Rings references just as soon as I'm able, but for now, they're going to continue. So that's just great. Okay, we found
here. Let's take a closer look.
A Nephilim monument.
We're cut off. They'll be upon us at any moment.
Okay, so it looks like...
Stand firm, brothers, and they will sing of our valor through the ages.
Okay.
The enemy is here. For glory!
Skewer the Nephilim curd!
Okay, so looks like some kind of mini event. The Eternal War. Defeat the enemies of the spirits. Okay. We'll do that. No sweat. Leave it to us. We're firing Ebolas left, right and centre. And I don't know if you know this, but Ebola's pretty deadly, actually. Maybe not as deadly as Zika or AIDS. Actually, probably more dangerous. Definitely more dangerous than AIDS. I think people can live with AIDS. In fact, I don't think it. I'm HIV positive. Okay, so we've completed this event.
We are not the first to have fought this skirmish.
I studied these battles in Cain's books, but seeing them is much worse.
Okay, so yeah, we got some doubloons for our efforts. Nothing too amazing. We've got some
Repel
more elites
them,
here.
My brothers.
Repel them, my brothers. It's Brother Sepsis, whatever his name was. I didn't catch the rest of it, but we're not too fussed about what his name was because he's dead. And hopefully he'll drop us some sweet loot for killing. So again, we're seeing more of these kind of... excuse me, we're seeing more of these kind of explosions after people die, and yeah, that's where shit goes down, and you can get pretty injured. Now in the Warrior's Rest, and there's a book here.
Alaric says that our people can survive the coming battle, but I saw the truth in his eyes. Why did he order me to guard the Beacon of Honor? Those shambling things are slaughtering my people in the forest above, and there's nothing I can do to stop it.
So I think that was Alaric again speaking. Alaric sounds like, I'm trying to think of it, it sounds a little bit like a vegetable or spice. I think I'm thinking of, is it turmeric?
Feel my wrath!
Something like that.
There,
people using cooking. Or maybe I'm thinking of some kind of disease. I'm not too sure, but either way, his name sounds like something else to me. Maybe it is just to me. Maybe I'm just completely batshit insane.
Me.
In any event, we've got another elite to fight. We're going to throw down some Ebolas, because yeah, the damage on these is actually pretty nice. And also in doing so, as you can see, using our rapid fire too often drains our hatred really fast. So we need to be cautious of that. We need to do a little bit more of resource management, I feel. Cat's traps, nice. So we've got ourselves some yellow gloves with a little bit more dex on them and some life per hit, which will certainly help with keeping us alive. And we've found the Beacon of Honor, which is great. Okay, good. So what I do know is that you can actually teleport back to the Drowned Temple to save ourselves a bit of time, and we're going to do just that. And we're going to speak to Turmeric and hopefully find out what kind of sweet stir-fry he's going to put on for us. Is turmeric used in curries? Maybe it's used in curries. And we've got our dwarf face again.
The temple is open. Enter and defeat the guardians within. Although they are my brothers, they will seek your death when you enter.
I cannot fault them for doing their duty.
Well, Sean Bean is up for us being attacked, so that's
Look
really kind.
Look at this architecture. This predates the Sin War.
I'm not too sure what kind of architecture she's talking about. The whole place looks like a bit of a mess to me. Maybe she's got more of an eye for that type of thing than I do. Let's get some attack speed going, because that'd be sweet. And we found Ezek, ancient Nephilim champion. For an ancient
Rise,
Nephilim champion, he doesn't seem to be
Rise,
that difficult to kill.
Do
he is spinning to win, as you can see. Oh, they're all spinning to win.
Spin to win, till they die, if you're just as they will climb. Spin to win, face them all, just one silence and they fall. Take all day, spin to get away, silence does them in. When you know they have thin skin, spin to win, yeah! Spin, yeah! Win!
Which is nice. Ancient Nephilim Defender, Keeper and Guardian. So there's three kind of ancient Nephilim dudes here that want nothing more in life than to slay people that enter this temple. Which you'd have thought for a lonely soul they'd just be a little bit more, you know, welcoming. Turmeric has teleported in, and he's got something
Your
to say.
Your strength rivals that of our greatest champions. What now do you think you are? You may enter our most sacred place.
Okay, so that was
the
all...
The spirit speaks the truth. This was a good place. I can feel it.
Well, why don't you just fucking marry this place, then? Okay, so we've been allowed entrance to this. What's this on the floor here? I can't see what that quite is. Sean Bean, get out of the way. I don't know what that is. It looks like maybe a haunch of meat. I'm not sure. But...
The noble human fought his way here just to die.
You again.
And who is this you bring with you? Adria's daughter? She has power within her.
Oh.
No matter. Your mother will soon share your fate, little one. The shard is mine. Fill this temple with their blood!
What did she mean, my mother will share my fate? Could my mother be alive after all these years?
She's trying to distract you. Don't listen to her.
And what is the power within you that she spoke of?
Yeah, what is it
this
there?
This fight was too easy. She's toying with us. We must get back to Uncle Deckard right away.
Okay. But it looks like what we have
the
done...
The worldstone has been changed. Our children are born weak and suffer short lives. The demon Nereza promised to restore their power, but instead turned them into misshapen creatures and sent them to war against us. We may die, but not before she is sent back to the burning hells.
Okay, so he's pretty pissed off about this ordeal. But we have found the second sword shard for our friend back in town. And we're going to take it to Deckard the Cane. Deckard of the Cane.
Magda
to see what he
close
says.
On our heels. We must find the last piece quickly.
I remember a glow streaking towards a fishing village.
That must be Wortham.
Ah, brilliant, dear Leah. Have the ferryman take you there.
Okay, alright, Deckard Cane's pissed off into... This is his house, that's Cane's house. Good, let's talk to the stranger. Mysterious Coven.
Have you fought the Coven before?
I cannot say, but there is something about them, a darkness, that is known to me.
What do you mean?
The Coven may be part of a greater evil. Perhaps I intended to fight it.
If you are to fight, you will need your sword.
Okay, alright. I don't know what that big glow was that came off us then, but Deckard Cane had something else to say. Let's go and have a chat. Or he didn't. Is there anything in his house? There's a book! Of course there is.
I wish that Leia could live a different life, a more normal life. But alas, such is not her fate. When I pass, there is none but her to continue my work, and the future of this world hangs in the balance.
Deckard Cane again, single bed. At least he had the kind of foresight to put it next to the wall, unlike Leia, who just kind of stuck it in the middle of her room like some kind of hillbilly. Okay, so we've been asked to go to the ferryman. There are some people over here to talk to. There's the scoundrel. Let's talk to him.
So where are you from?
Kingsport, the city by the sea, home to the great merchant fleets and endless nets of reeking fish.
I've seen it. What did you do there?
I am between jobs at the moment.
Dishonorable jobs, no doubt.
Nonsense. I am the most honest thief you will ever meet. Wanted, one relic, scarlet, roughly the size of a man's fist. It was stolen 2 months past during a deplorable theft from the Merchants Guild Bank. Those apprehended were not in possession of the item. The relic is greatly missed by its rightful owner, or... who offers a reward for its safe return.
Unlike
that
some
would not
people.
Be wise.
Oops, I didn't mean to interrupt that dialogue there, but nonetheless, I did. Okay, I so thinking. We've been asked to go and talk to the ferryman. And it looks like we're going on a boat. Oh, it's not really the most impressive of boats, but it's
I must go to Wortham. I will take you, but beware. Smoke rises from the village.
Okay, so we're going to Wortham, but beware, smoke rises from the village. So if you have asthma...
They're destroying the town! Get out while you can! Okay. By all that is holy, the town is burning!
By all that is holy, the town is burning. Okay, it's not the best news. Looks like a priest has snuffed it and dropped his book along the way. Let's read what he has to say for himself.
One of the men retrieved a strange artifact in his nets. It looked like a hilt of an ancient blade, but I know it must be more. A fisherman argued with me, but I convinced him to leave it in the safety of the chapel. A holy place, or a holy relic.
Okay, so according to whichever priest decided to snuff it, right over there, dropping his book,
those who defy the power.
The sword shard should be here. Can we go in here? No, we can't go in there. So that's good news. We're on our way to finding
Please.
The third piece of the
My
sword.
My family's hiding in the chapel with the rest of the townsfolk. We must get to them.
Don't run off! You'll get yourself killed!
You probably will get yourself killed. She's not wrong.
Glory to you.
Okay, we've leveled up as well, which is fantastic. We've unlocked a new active skill category.
The people
so
in
we
the
now
chapel
have
need my help.
A button number
I'm going
three.
On ahead.
Fools! You cannot keep the sword from me!
It's
this
Magda
is bad.
Again.
My servants will burn this town to ashes!
Okay, so again, as you can see, I'm just kind of laying down a caltrop, using that to slow stuff down. This guy's throwing fireballs at us, which is just a goddamn nonsense.
I hear something
and then
coming.
Rolling away to avoid taking damage.
These creatures won't go down easily.
More elites to fight. And we've run out of discipline again. So yeah, I do need to pay a little bit more attention to my discipline and hatred. These guys are electrified, as you can see. They are throwing electricity all over the ground, which is just a nuisance. Here's the priest. Maybe that
you
was not...
You saved us. We owe you our lives.
Yeah, you do, actually. Have you got any gold? I'll take the gold. No? Okay.
The hilt of an ancient sword fell near this village recently. Perhaps you have seen it.
We found it days ago. I wish we'd never brought it here. Come, I left Virgil to guard it. We will be glad to be rid of it.
Okay, so
We're
they've
going
got
back
the sword.
To Tristram to check on Uncle Deckard.
And we've got a new sign here. It looks like a crucifix and also a shiny new torso piece, which is great. It's got more dexterity on it, nearly double the dexterity, just over double the dexterity, a little bit more health, and increases our hatred regeneration by a little bit. So that's great. We'll put that on straight away.
Your hate has made you powerful.
The new bow that we got, not quite as powerful as the last one, so we'll be selling that. New braces, the leather cuffs of the hawk, more damage. We'll take the damage. Good stuff. But let's first check out what skills we managed to acquire, which looks like quite a few actually. For level 14, which doesn't seem like a particularly momentous level, but nonetheless, we've been given some things. So, we could increase our Ebola radius to 20 yards, that sounds good, but we've also been given this. Evasive fire. Shoot a spread of bolts that hits primary enemy for 200% weapon damage and two additional enemies for 100% damage. If an enemy is in front of you at close range, you will backflip away 5 yards. Now that does sound pretty exciting. Let's go for that just to see what that looks like, and then we might change back to the more powerful Ebola, because I like the sound of that. Smokescreen has obtained a rune, and what we could do, so we're not actually using smokescreen, but we could have, is vanish behind a wall of smoke, becoming momentarily invisible for 1 second, and whilst doing so, we could gain 100% movement speed whilst invisible. It sounds tempting, but we'll leave it as is for the time being, but we haven't unlocked slot number 3 for a third skill, so let's have a look. We've unlocked Fan of Knives. Throw knives out in a spiral around you, dealing a butt ton of damage to all enemies within 20 yards. Your knives will also slow the enemy's movement speed by 60% for 1 second. So we'll use that. That sounds exciting. Let's go down into Wortham Chapel Cellar. Hopefully they've got plenty of wine, maybe not just bookcases or 49 gold. No, it looks like they've just got bookcases, which is not the best. We could do with some Casal del Diablo, if you've ever heard of that. So this is our new ability, which fires out like three things. And as you can see, there is actually a mechanic in the game for destroying items. And if you destroy a whole bunch of crap in one go, you get a slight run speed increase.
While you were on your hero's errand here, I captured all three sword pieces and your friend.
Oh, that's not the best.
I should have known. I must get back to Kane's house.
Okay, so Magda, who looks curiously like Maleficent from Snow White, has apparently got all three pieces of the sword, which is not the best. Let's go back to Kane's house in New Tristram. Oh, shit is going down.
It's your choice, Kane. Either use your Herodric arts to repair the sword, or your dear Leah dies a horrible death.
Oh, this pain, this destruction. What is the sword to you?
To me, nothing. To my master, Belial, everything.
Oh, no. Holy crap.
Your rage is overwhelming, girl. You win this round, but if the sword cannot be mine, I'll claim the one it's bound to. In the end, the blade shall be mine.
Uncle, you can't die.
Nothing can stop that now. But there is one last thing I must do.
What is it?
The sword must be made whole.
Give it to Aragorn. He is the one true king.
Just as I suspected, the sword is of the high heavens. The stranger is an angel. Heed the journal. The truth lies within.
Uncle Deckard!
No! Shit. Well, it looks like Deckard Cain snuffed it, and that's a real shame, because he was pretty cool, actually. I mean, he was a bit of a pain in the ass, but when all was said and done, he was actually kind of a nice guy. So that's a great shame, and we'll hold a big funeral for him. Maybe like a kind of Viking funeral, you know, where we send him off on a boat, and then someone fires an arrow. Maybe I can fire the arrow, because look, I'm pretty fucking good at it. I probably won't fire, like, rapid fire. It seems a bit unnecessary. But either way, we can fire an arrow and, you know, his boat will set fire and then he'll join his people, the Haradrim, or whatever. Anyway, that'll do it for this time. Thanks very much for watching, and as always, I'll see you next time!